Hello makers, let's talk about servos, especially this one, the SG90. It's a very small servo, weighs only 9 grams, works with 5 volts, and is perfect to use with an Arduino. It comes with 3 attachments that you can pin on and fix it with a screw. But we're using this one for demonstration, so you can see the movement. To control a servo, we cannot use every pin on the Arduino, only those with PWM. This PWM end pins are those with those wavy lines, for example, pin 3, pin 5, 9, 10, and 11. So if you want to hook it up, you choose one of those PWM pins. Let's choose pin 9. It has this wavy line. We are in need of 5 volts and of course ground. And the ground line is marked here with a brown cable. Pretty shitty, huh? So, that's nearly all it takes. Let's start our computer and move the servo around. And of course, Arduino and working with the servo is very, very easy. We have our own library for it, Servo.h. You don't need to install it over the library manager because the servo library will already be into the base installation of the Arduino IDE. We define our own servo. Let's call it a blue servo because the server is pretty bluish. This time we're only using the setup for everything because we want only to see the server in action once. Of course, restarting the serial monitor because what's anything to work with if you can't debug it on a PC screen? Our blue server we attach to the pin we connected it to. It's pin 9. This time we didn't use a variable for this because we only need this number once and it would be quite an overhead defining a variable only for this one purpose. And the cool thing about the servo, you cannot only set the position of the servo, you can also read the current position of the servo. And that's where we start. We're reading the current position of the servo and print it out to the serial monitor, just because we can do it. And then we're moving the servo around. A servo can be controlled if you're putting a value to it from 0 to 180. And why setting one position when we can have it all? So, in this loop, you're going to every available position of the servo, setting it to this position, waiting for 50 milliseconds, and again, setting the next position till we are finished. So let's try it out. So we are now uploading the sketch. And let's see what happens. Yeah, that was all the magic. It moved to the start position, position 0, and then go through all the position from 0 to 180. Well, now we found our next useful gadget for the Arduino. As you can see, there are possibilities how to use it. For example, you can use it with this ultrasonic sensor to measure the distance of your surroundings without having multiple sensors of this. Or you could make a cat toy, or you can even manually turn switches with it. The possible numbers of users for this are quite enormous. I hope you liked this video, and if you have an idea how to implement the servo in a project, please let me know in the comments. So, be creative and bye!